Blossomers. Now I'd like to welcome the Blossomers. Please, Blossomers, come on stage.
Good morning. We are Blossomers, ready to present a memory verse and a song. Sit back, relax, and have a banana smile. Galatians chapter 5 verse 22, it says, fruits of the Holy Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control, abound these no though.
Church, you can do better. Please let's have our seats. Kindly let's have our seats. Thank you. Thank you for bearing with us. Aren't they beautiful? They are.
Thank you, Blossomers. May God continue using you. Now we have an exciting session. The QA, and I'd like to welcome Precious and Cyrus.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord again. My name is Precious.
And I, Cyrus.
And we will be taking you through an exciting session. Our junior church lessons also comprises of Bible trivia. We are going to take you through an exciting session. Ask your neighbor, how well do you know the Bible? Ask them, how well do you know the Bible? This is where we will put you to test.
Kindly raise up your hand if you know the answer. As teachers normally says, no chorus answers. So, hapa, hakuna kuhepa. Kama unajua na kupoint, unasema, okay?
Please put your gadgets down. No googling, no discussion.
Are you ready,
just,
guys?
Just you, your mind, and God.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
On which island was Paul shipwrecked? This question goes to the father to bride. On which island was Paul shipwrecked? Wrong. Yes? Wrong. Mr. Wilfred. I said no discussion. Kindly raise your hand if you know the answer. Okay, bright. Wrong. Correct. Catch.
Malta.
Paul's ship was wrecked in Malta.
This is now the easy one, the easiest of them all. How many times did Samuel was called by God?
How many times was Samuel called?
How many times did Samuel called by God? You know we have some goodies here. If you know the answer, raise up your hand. Your name? Three.
Wrong.
No.
Gender.
Grace. Yes.
How many books are in the Old Testament and New Testament? Kama ujui usomi Biblia. Melala. In the Old Testament and New. Hey, watu wa melala jo.
I'm drawing the Bible.
Beth will help them. The other way around. The other way around.
Who was the great grandfather of King David? Hey, wa, hey.
Hey. Hey. Parents, you're failing us. You're failing us. Inside imekauka. Nahitaji kunyunyuziwa maji.
No, not Abraham.
Kindly raise your hand if you know. No discussion again.
Reverend Mwidi.
Wrong.
Wrong. Yeah, almost. Bright. Help them. Who was the great grandfather of King David? Yes, the correct answer is Boaz.
Kama ujui swali, where do you read the Bible? My gosh. Who replaced Judas Iscariot? Lillian. Who replaced Judas Iscariot?
Now, come on, Julie. On the Sermon of the Mountain, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall.
Yo mkono kila mtu akweju. No korasansas. Please. Or you'll be disqualified.
We, he said, mnahitaji maombi. Mama Precious. Yes.
Another one. On which island was John when he wrote the book of Revelation? Reverend Mwidi. Correct. People who read the Bible. People who read the Bible.
Sign a tajum twice side. Jump, participate. My bright price was 1,000 Philistines foreign skins. Who am I?
We'll pick random then if you don't raise your hand. A trial also. A trial.
Mama Mulwa. Baba Bright.
No, not no. Samson. My father.
Baba Precious. My bride price was 1,000 Philistines for skins. Who am I? No.
women in the house, please raise your hands. Monica.
The answer is Michael.
Mikael.
It comes from the books, a book of 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 25.
Go read at home. My husband and I were tent makers. Who are we?
Kama ujui hiyo.
Na umeolewa. Umeowa na ujui. Yes, Reverend Dixon. Yes. And? Yes, yes.
The next question. We demanded for our inheritance from Moses, since our father had died and left no son. Who are we? Who are we? I repeat. We demanded for our inheritance from Moses, since our father had died and left no son. Who are we? Mama Ruth.
Mrs. Opot.
The answer is daughters of Zelphas.
Daughters of Japata Zelphas. Sweetie. Amjapata asomeni Biblia. Mtaona wakikula kwa macho. We went to Moab from Bethlehem, married Moabite ladies, and together with our father died in Moab. Who are we? Unaenda kutafuta bibi nchi ingine na ujui. Foster? No. They are men. We went to Moab from Bethlehem, married Moabite ladies, and together with our father died in Moab. Who are we? Raise your hand. Yes. Chilion. She's right.
Now, this is the easy one. I was saved by a servant girl and got healed of leprosy. Who am I?
Fathers, you are failing us.
Naaman.
I was visited by a king of Israel and asked to bring back Samuel's spirit to life. Who am I? The answer is Witch of Endor. I said no discussion.
Kama hiyo ujui, sijui niseme aje. I wrestled with an angel till daybreak. Who am I?
All hands up.
I wrestled with an angel till saim na participate. Mama Ruth? Yes.
How many animals got into the ark of Noah? Yes, over there. No. Yes, Mr. Moura. You have raised your hand. Bethuel? No. Gabu has an idea. Yes, seven of each. They were the unclean and the clean ones.
Asai Swali, how many children did Abraham have? How many children?
All hands up.
Did Abraham have?
Raise your hand.
Mama Precious.
Yes.
Yes.
I had six fingers and six toes, and I was 6 feet tall. Who am I? Raise your hands. All of your hands should be up. Father Cyrus. Pardon? Yes, you're right.
While in Egypt, the Israelites stayed in which place? While in Egypt, the Israelites stayed in which place?
Unasoma Biblia na ujui.
Pia hii ni ngumu. Yes.
What was the sixth plague? Gadgets down, please, Reverend Dixon. What was the sixth plague?
No discussion, Baba Bright. Natakikana ku read the Bible.
No discussion, Baba Bright. Pastor Marty? No. No, not frogs, Bethuel. No. Foster.
Recently. Mama Mulua.
Pardon? Boils, you are right.
This is the last question and the easy one. Which is the shortest book in the Bible? Which is the shortest book in the Bible?
Julius. No.
Almost.
Raise your hand. No. Yes. Pardon? No.
No. Yes.
Yes. But raise your hand.
Hand.
Thank you for participating, and all those who haven't participated, please go read your Bibles.
Na kitabu hicho ni cha Yohana. Yohana wa 14, mstari wa kwanza hadi wa 10. Ifuatayo, Yesu ni njia ya kwenda kwa Baba. Yesu aliwaambia msifadhaike mioyoni mwenu. Muaminini Mungu, niaminini na mimi pia. Nyumbani mwa baba yangu mna makao mengi. Kama isingekuwa hivyo, ningalikwisha waambieni. Sasa nakwenda kuwatayarishieni nafasi. Na nikwende kuwatayarishieni nafasi, nitarudi na kuwachukueni kwangu. Ili nanyi muwe pale mahali nilipo mimi. Mnajua njia ya kwenda huko ninakokwenda. Toma akamuuliza Bwana, hatujui mahali unakwenda. Tutawezaje basi kuijua hiyo njia? Yesu akawajibu, mimi ni njia na ukweli na uhai. Hakuna awezaye kuenda kwa baba ila kwa kupita kwangu. Ikiwa mnanijua mimi, mnamjua baba yangu pia. Na tangu sasa mnamjua tena mmekwisha muona. Filipo akamwambia Bwana, tuonyeshe baba nasi tutatosheka. Yesu akawaambia, nimekaa nanyi muda wote huo nawe Filipo haujanijua. Aliyekwisha niona mimi amemuona baba. Unawezaje basi kusema tuonyeshe baba? Mwisho wa neno. Mungu awabariki. Asanteni, Mungu awabariki, mbaki na neema ya Bwana.
Pull you down, no. One day you go run this town, no. spray me money. Baby, go call you and me. Yusuf, go host the party. Amen. 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 Dangote, go be your friend.
Amen.
Tedela, go be your friend.
Amen.
Adenuga, go be your guy.
Amen.
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 Amen. Elubelu, go be your guy.
Amen.
Samad, go be my guy.
Thank you, Springer. Can we clap for them
again?
Amen. Amen. Your life.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord again. My name is Bright, and me and Joel will be your preachers for the day.
Love is the greatest command in the Bible, and we see God as a good example in John 3:16, which says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." We should see how God loved us and gave his only Son to die for us so that we don't have to pay with our sins, with our death. Praise the Lord. And on to my first point. First, I'm going to ask you, how do you feel when you're loved? Anyone? How do you feel when you're loved? For me, I feel when I'm loved, I can impact someone's life, but I can touch someone's life by changing them, by loving them. And when you want to love someone, you have to be patient with them because others can be bullies, others can not, they always have a problem, or others are not just perfect, and no one is perfect, but we should be patient as we love them. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
My second point is, love is not jealous, proud, boastful, or rude. For example, when you see your friend, your neighbor, your sibling, anyone with something, a new car, a new purse, anything, we should not be jealous, being mean to them, and not talking to them just because they have something new. Instead, we should congratulate them and wish them best of luck. Amen?
Amen.
So, when you're the one who has all those new and good things, you should not be proud and start bragging around, showing everyone to be jealous of you. Amen?
Amen.
Over to you, Bright.
Humans on their own are not able to love. Only Jesus can enable us to love. Humans are selfish. Humans' nature is selfish. For example, can you love without God? It's Jesus who helps us to love others. I have the privilege to see my younger brother growing. As you all know him, now anytime I go take a toy, example toy car, he'll start crying for it. Anytime our parents buy for us something, he will take his own and start throwing tantrums to my own. At times he might throw a fit and pretend he is crying, trying to manipulate us. Hi, parents in the house. This goes to show us that the Adamic nature is real. Over to you, Jira.
Praise the Lord. To my third point is, love does not demand in its own ways, which means love is not selfish, and love is sacrificial and costly. If you want to love someone, you have to sacrifice something. For example, when you're cleaning the house and then you see a particle of a glass and that can harm your little brother, you should take it because you love him and you don't want him to get hurt. Or you should take it because you don't want anybody in the house to get harmed or hurt. Praise the Lord. Over to my fourth point is, love is not irritable and easily angered. So, for example, let's take an example. When your friend or your sibling, anyone stepped on you or hurt you by mistake, you should not shout at them and ask them, "We, ukona shida akili? Mbona umenikanyaga?" you should just understand them and forgive them because it was by mistake. Amen?
Amen.
Or let's use another example. When you go to a restaurant and your waitress pours your drink on you, you should not tell them, we, avunja umenimwagia hii sasa ona shida yako. Hii ni nguo nzuri sana. Mbona umenichafulia? Utaninunulia ingine. You should just help them clean up and you should help them clean up and give them a little tip when you're going. Amen?
Amen.
Over to you, Bright.
Paul, writing to the Church of Corinth, tells us what love is and that love is our benchmark. Let's open to the book of 1 Corinthians 13, 1 to 8. It says, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Love is the greatest. God is the author of love. In fact, he is love. In John 3:16, it's love that compelled God to give his only son to us, who people did not want anything to do with him. He had only one son, and it was hard to let him go to the cross for our sins. Of course, he could send an angel, but it was Jesus was the greatest sacrifice. Over to you, Jewel.
So over to my fifth point, which says, love does not rejoice in justice, but rejoices when the truth wins out. Which means, have you ever been in a situation when you see your colleague or your friend being accused, being falsely accused by your other colleague or your friend, and you're just sitting there? We should stand out for the truth. If your boss asks you what happened here and the other person is blaming your colleague, you should stand out for them and say the truth. Amen?
Amen?
Over to my sixth point, which says, love does not lose faith or hope. It is always hopeful and endures every circumstance. Which means when you need a relative, a friend, somebody that you know and you are really close to be healed, you should trust in God, because if you love God, you'll trust him and wait for him to do this, the provision. Because there are times when there are temptations and when you see that God has not done his provision, and you start saying, no, God has not provided for me. God has not healed this person or done this. Because we should trust in him because we love him. There's a verse that says, write down your vision board. Even though it hurts, it shall come to pass. Which means you should write down your vision board. Even though it takes a long time to come, it will come, pass. Over to you, Bright.
Anytime whether we want to be tied by miracles, miracles are good, right? But if we do them without love, they are zero. To God, they are meaningless. In 1 John 4:7, let's open to the book of 1 John 4:7. Who will read that verse?
Anyone?
Mr. Wilfred, read for us. 1 John 4:7. Yes. Thank you. It is not an if statement that we are to be our Father's children, then genuine love ought to flow freely in us. If God has asked us to love other people, then we should. It's hard for other people, including those people who do bad things to you, like stealing. Over to you, Jewel.
And over to my last point, verse 8, which means which says, prophecy and speaking in unknown languages will be useless, but love will last forever. For example, you're on your way to church and you're very prayerful. You give the biggest and the best offerings. And on your way, you pass someone who needs help. That will be useless. But when you help the needy on your way, where you are going, that will be love. And you will also help impact that person's life. Amen. Right, what month are we in?
We're in December.
Oh, parents, we are in December. What act of kindness and love have you shown to other people since January? Anyone? Okay. It's not too late, because even this during season of Christmas, we can also help and show other people love. If you are done hanging out with your relatives for Christmas, you can go take a few stuff that you think can help the needy, and even visit the children's home. You can also go hang out with them and make them feel unlonely. That way, they will also have love, and the bullies will also have love in their heart. Amen? And one thing I forgot to say, maybe you are in school, maybe high school or college, and someone bullied you and you met them somewhere. You should show them love, because love does not pay evil for evil. Amen?
Amen.
Over to you, Bright.
Love, the world defines love from a selfish perspective, so we miss it when we define it in their terms. Wahenga, these were people thought to be full of wisdom, said, Mpenda anayekupenda, asiyekupenda? It's love that compelled Jesus to heal even on the Sabbath. Though Jesus and his fellow people were strict on their Mosaic laws, but Jesus could not be held down by traditions. That's why he could not relate with the people who could not relate with the Pharisees. After all he said and done, love remains to be the greatest of all. During this season of Christmas, let us spread the love, for love can be felt miles away.
Come on, church, you can do better than that.
And I had something to say, which is when you meet you, because Jesus dined with the tax collector Zacchaeus. He did not say, I will not love this one and impact his life because he's a bad person. He went and helped impact Zacchaeus' life. Now Zacchaeus was a good person, which shows us that we should love even the worst. Even those who mistreated you, those who did bad things to you, we should also love them.
In the seasons of Moses, they used to take lambs as sacrifices. But Jesus came and paid it all after he died on the cross for our sins. In another chapter, it says that Jesus was even asking God to take this cup away from him. It was not easy because he had a human body like ours. But he did it anyway for our sins.
Hallelujah. Church, have you heard the message from these wonderful servants? The message of love came out in simplicity, but it is a message of love. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. Please help me appreciate Bright and Jewel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please have your seats. Praise the Lord. That is what Junior Church is all about. We are bringing up children in the ways of the Lord, and they are becoming confident that they can stand and share the word of God. Amen? How many of us here, adults, wanaweza simama hapa tu? Tuseme tu ukweli. Unless umesukumwa ile kusukumwa mpaka unasema tu sasa ndasema nini? Praise the name of the Lord. People ask, sasa mnatoanga wapi maneno? Amen? Is it true? Mwingine wanasemanga sasa nitaanzia wapi? Praise the name of the Lord. Mwingine akifika hapa maneno inapotea. Praise the name of the Lord. So we bless the Lord for the confidence. We bless the Spirit of God for using and ministering to us through these beautiful children. Let's appreciate the Lord again. Amen. Amen. And just to emphasize on the message that they have brought us today. And you know what? These children, when we were preparing, we just told them our theme is love. They went, they researched, they sat, they prepared. We were meeting to listen to what they have. Parents, are you taking notes? Are you taking notes? As your child comes from Sunday school on Sunday evening, there's something that we usually give, not every other day, but make a point of following up. What is my children learning? What is my child learning? Amen? So that you're able even to walk with them, disciple them. In this year, we have had, I think, 90% of our children give their lives to Jesus. This year, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And so our challenge to all of us is that we are in a discipleship journey. Help this child understand what salvation is all about. Walk with them. And above all, model Christ to them. Don't just tell them, go to church. Let them see you in church. Don't just tell them, pray. Let them see you pray. Praise the name of the Lord. When you come to church, usikuwe mgwana. The praise and worship team are telling us, chezea Yesu, and uko hapo tu umesimama kama mlingoti. Praise the name of the Lord. These children are watching. They are watching. And you know what? The first place that they learn is from home. When they come to church, usiseme tu, Sunday school teachers, we watawashughulikia. Mi nataka nikae nisikize neno. God bless you. Utasikiza neno. But after you've skizad neno, when you go home, please follow up to know what that child has learned. Amen? And so I just want to emphasize in a few minutes so that we'll invite the pastor to pray for us. We are talking about love. Amen? And these children have brought out a picture of love. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, 4 to 8. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It is not boastful. Does not keep a record of wrong. This year, we're in December. If you look back, probably kuna karekodi umeweka mahali. Just search your heart. Kuna record. Mtu alikukosea January, tarehe 5, ukaandika. Mkaenda February, March, tena akakukwaza tena, ukaandika. Praise the name of the Lord. May the Lord help us as we wind up the year. We are not going to close with a record of wrong. Let them go. Pray for people with love. Praise the name of the Lord. Allow yourself to love them, even those who have hurt you. Amen? And number one, we can trust in God's love. We can trust in God's love. Amen? How can we trust? Because he says in John 3:16, he loved the world so much that he gave. If he loved us so much, he gave his son for us, then we can trust his love. Praise the name of the Lord. He's not giving us a love that is not trustworthy or dependable. By the fact that he gave, the act of sacrificing his only begotten son means that we can trust him. Amen? We can trust him and we can trust in his love. And then we can also learn from the scripture of today that our salvation is an expression of God's love. That is John 3:16, as was quoted by our preachers of the day. Please write down Romans 5:8. while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. Write down John 4, verse 10. It talks about God's love. It also says that God's love does not discriminate. Praise the name of the Lord. God is impartial. He does not choose this over that. Amen? And so as we model the love of Christ, we should also be impartial. We should not love because people are being good to us. Christianity or the love of Christ loves even those who do not deserve to be loved. Amen? Love expresses even to those whom we feel, praise the name of the Lord. That is not what the love of Christ is all about. Then our ability to love is enabled through God's love. As the preachers have told us, only God can enable us to love. Ni kweli. There are people you can try to look at na ukiangalia unasema aki huyu, huyu haezi pendeka. Praise the name of the Lord. Even that one, that difficult one, you know them. Only God can enable you and I to love them. Praise the name of the Lord. Write down John 13, 34 and 35. And also write down 1 John chapter 3, verse 16 to 20. Please take time as you go home, read those scriptures. We'll not be able to read them right now. And then the other thing about love is that love is a fruit of the Spirit. The blossomers read a scripture for us, Galatians 5, 22. The fruit of the Spirit is what? Love. It begins with love. Praise the name of the Lord. So the Spirit of God within us enables us to love. On our own, we do not have the capacity, or our capacity is limited as human beings. But when we have the Spirit of God, we can be able to express love. Amen? And then when we rest and abide in God, the love of God outpours onto others. When we abide in God, God is able to pour his love in us. And as a result, we become a channel of blessing to others. We are loved. The word of God says we love because he first loved us. Amen? We love because he first loved us. Praise the name of the Lord. It's through our love that the world will know that we belong to Christ. Jesus said, if you are my disciples, you will love one another. And the world will know. How will the world know? When you love one another. Praise the name of the Lord. And then finally, we can have confidence in God's love. When we think about love, our confidence, the psalmist in Psalms 136 talks about the love of God as unfailing. Praise the name of the Lord. He echoes over and over again, his love endures forever. If you want a love that endures forever, come to Jesus. The love of man may fail you over and over again, but the love of God can never fail. Praise the name of the Lord. As we look back upon his loving faithfulness from the beginning of time, we can grow in our assurance that God will continue to vindicate us as his children and to promote his kingdom until his plan and purpose comes to full fruition. Praise the name of the Lord. Tell your neighbor for me, love. It is a season for love. And Jewel has asked a question. From January, we are in December. What have you done to touch a life? As a matter of fact, in Cornerstone, we have one thing that a statement that we say. Come on, Cornerstonians. Touching? Say it like you believe it. Touching? And let me ask that question again. How many people have you touched this year with the love of Christ? Alama ya dukuduku. Let us stand on our feet. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I would want to invite the junior church team here. I'm privileged to work with a very supportive team. I would want you to appreciate our teachers, Teacher Tina, Teacher Helen, Teacher Alice, and Teacher Agnes. Someone call for me, Teacher Agnes. Teacher Saumu, please come with the children. Please stand over that side. I will be requesting our pastors to come and just pray over us. Thank you for allowing us to minister this day. Thank you for allowing these children to bring out their best through the grace of God, by the grace of God. Amen. And so even as we go to Christmas, we want to release them and to bless them. And we want to remind ourselves as a church that there are people out there who need our love. there are people out there who desire a touch. Praise the name of the Lord. As you celebrate your Christmas, as you go to eat that nyama choma and mbuzi choma out there, can you remember to share with somebody who does not have? Amen? Hallelujah. Are we all here? I mentioned all our teachers, Teacher Tina. I'd like the teachers to just come up here, please. Please come, please come. You are wonderful ministers of God, and I want to acknowledge you. Teacher Helen, Teacher Agnes, please come, please come. These are my fellow ministers. This work that you have seen today is not one man's work. It is a teamwork. Praise the name of the Lord. A teamwork that also entails of very supportive parents. Praise the name of the Lord. And of course, our pastors, Reverend Dixon, Reverend Withy, together with your wives and the entire leadership, the elders, the deacons, whatever we have done today, it has their backing, it has their full support. And we feel the honor, and we want to bless the Lord for that. Amen. This is Teacher Alice, this is Teacher Helen, Teacher Agnes, and Teacher Tina. Boy child, praise the name of the Lord. Our appeal for the boy child, amen? These young men here need role models. They need mentors. We are not saying that we are not giving them, but there is a place for a father figure. Church, are you there? As a young person, are you there as a man? And you're asking, where can I serve? Please come to the junior church. Hapa, hatunanga formula. When we come, we learn from one another. And above all, we allow the Holy Spirit to teach us. Amen? So don't be afraid of coming. Just come as you are. We'll be able to learn from one another. And we'll be able to raise this generation for the glory of God. Karibu, Pastor.
Bwana sifiwe. Today is the greatest day in this church. You know, when I look back at the age of these children, we could do nothing as far as the work of God is concerned. We were just being pushed, go to church, but we could not understand what we were doing. But let me tell you, there is a seed that you put in your child. The moment you put them in the house of God at this little age, there is a seed that is being deposited in their life. And you know, seed never dies. Seed grows with seasons. And the moment you let your child to be used of God at their little age, you are depositing a seed that will grow to maturity and become what they want to be. The people you see being great, they did not become great when they were of age. They started becoming great when they were of this age. So we bless God for these children, for ministering to us this day, this way. It's marvelous, it's wonderful. And I just want us to raise up our hands together just to bless the Lord for them, and just to declare blessings upon the teachers, upon the children, upon our junior church, because they are wonderful people. They are so, so good, and the Lord will bless them. And as they continue to serve Him, they will find favor in their lives. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for our junior church. We thank you for the teachers, Lord. We thank you for Teacher Anne. We thank you for Teacher Helen. We thank you for Teacher Agnes. We thank you for Teacher Alice. And we thank you, Jehovah Lord, for Teacher Tina. Lord God Almighty, for giving themselves to serve you and to bring up these children. We declare a blessing upon their lives. We declare a blessing upon their families. We declare a blessing upon their daily lives and their daily work in the name of Jesus. We pray for a blessing upon them. We declare a long life upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare no sickness will befall on them in the name of Jesus. Bless them as they serve you. Bless them as they bring up their families in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for these children. We thank you for the Springs team. We thank you for the Blossomers. We thank you, Jehovah Lord, God Almighty, even Jehovah Lord, for the victors, and Lord God Almighty, for the team. teams that have served us, Lord, this day, we declare a blessing upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we speak a blessing upon these children. We hide them in the blood of Jesus. We soak them in the blood of Jesus. We make a net of protection upon their lives. I declare the enemy will not see them. The enemy will not attack them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray the Lord God Almighty, you secure them from the perverse and the crooked world. That Lord God Almighty, none of these children will be entangled in substance abuse, in drug abuse, in Lord God Almighty, wayward ways in the name of Jesus. I declare greatness over their lives. In the name of Jesus, I speak life upon them. I speak greatness. I declare, Jehovah God, that our children will be great. In the name of Jesus, I cancel spirit of premature death over their lives in Jesus' name. I declare they will live to see their full age in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we just say thank you. Thank you for what you've done. We thank you, Lord, for you're such a faithful God. We just worship you for who you are. Receive all the praise. Receive all the honor and all the glory, for you are such a faithful God. Who is like you, Lord? What you can do, no man can do. We just say thank you for the ministry of our children, for what they have done today. Lord, it's a great milestone, even in this church. And we just lift your name and thank you and say, Lord, you are good. Receive all the praise, receive all the honor and all the glory, for there is none like you. In Jesus' mighty name, we do pray and I give thanks. Amen, 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 amen. Thank you, children. You can take your seats.